can we do like a quick kickoff, like 3, 2, 1? I just like, let's go, team. You know what I mean? Ready? I'll lead us. 3, 2, 1. Blast off!
To me, that looks like a rubber.
A rubber. We have a different term for a rubber. That's called an eraser. If you said that was a rubber in school, you'd probably get in trouble, honestly. Do you know what a rubber is, though, actually?
No, what is a rubber in America?
A rubber in America?
Is that like a condom? Is that what that
yeah,
is?
Yeah, it's a condom.
It's a condom,
yeah.
That's literally what we call a rubber.
That's an eraser in English. Like, can I borrow your eraser to erase that? How do you, like, say, how do you say the activity of that then?
So you just say, oh no, I've drawn something wrong. I'm just going to rub it out.
Wow. We say we drew something wrong. We're going to erase it.
You know, that's just weird. I would just call them bottoms or like trousers. Like smart trousers. They look like chinos.
Chinos isn't bad, but honestly, I don't know what is with everyone from UK and Europe as a whole calling pants trousers. It's like the funniest thing. We just call those pants. I would never describe someone's pants as like, hey, you got a nice pair of trousers on. Like,
yeah, but for me, that's just alien. Because pants, that's when like, right. Say if my little brother gets out the shower, he'll put his pants on and then his trousers. So like boxers, we call pants. I call this a jumper.
Wait.
I call it a jumper. And so does the whole of England. The whole of England will look at this and go, jumper.
Jumper. No, we call that, I'd say, I mean, see, I guess I'm different too in America. Like, there's 10 different terms for this. I'd say that's a sweatshirt. Other people would probably say that's a sweater. No, it's definitely a sweater.
Oh, that's easy. Trainers. I love trainers.
Wait, you call shoes trainers?
Yeah, I call them trainers. Why is that funny? I don't get it. What do you call them?
Like shoes. Wait, what? How do we have the same language but speak completely different? All right, so if you said like, I'm going to go on a run, but I forgot my shoes, you would say, I'm gonna go on a run, but oh shoot, I forgot my trainers.
Yeah, like, oh, I'm gonna go on a run. I better put my trainers on. Because if I just put a normal pair of shoes on, they're gonna get dirty. So to go on a run, you need to put a pair of trainers on, like runners.
That's interesting. Now, I don't think we have that many denominations of shoes, honestly.
Right, okay, I call this a flannel. I've got about six of them in my bathroom. You put one on the radiator, you put one on the windowsill, and you put one over your sink so you can wash your face before you go to bed and when you wake up.
You call that a flannel?
A flannel, yeah.
Oh my gosh, I call that a towel. A flannel is like, you never see the shirts I wear that's got like the checkered pattern on them?
Yeah.
What do you call that then?
I think we just call them the farmer shirts.
Farmer shirts, all right, that's fair. No, flannel, I mean, I've never heard that one.
I mean, it looks like a towel, but it looks like a smaller version of a towel. And a smaller version of
like
towel, a flannel.
Like a wash rag. That you like shower with it and wash your face with it?
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, we call that a wash rag.
That's weird. I've never heard a rag. Rag. Wash rag.
This is actually interesting. I didn't realize we speak the same language with such different terms on little stuff. Like, I've heard your terminology before with like the sort and like banter and stuff like that, but I didn't know there were so many differences.